Nurseries. It's just always blue sky, sunshine.
Chess trophy.
No, don't say that. What are you doing?
2023 chess champion.
An ex with whom you'd consider reconciling.
To the right.
Yeah.
So I went through to the finals for the Northwest Draughts Champion. Where are we, Russia? What are you doing? Right, so we're starting off the vlog because I'm back of the bungalow. So I just needed to do a couple of small bits for when Sandra comes tomorrow. And I'm looking for something. I can't find. I'm looking for some little eyes for something. And you know what? It's a beautiful day here. I'm just down the road from the nurseries. But I must admit, I have just driven through an almighty massive storm, torrential rain, lightning in the distance, but no thunder, no thunder. So I've just done what I needed to do, and I'm cooking some chicken while I'm here, and I'm gonna have a bath, wash my hair, have a shave while I'm here as well, because I can. But I'm just looking for something that Sandra had the other day, and I'm not sure where she's put things. Anyway, it doesn't really matter. The main little job is done and out of the way. Yeah, back. Come on, you Russia. Fly paper up there. We've got all the blue bottles are all back. And I've got this little zapper here. All the dead critters. So that was a product review you didn't see on the YouTube platform. It was something, another site that I do stuff on. And it's really bizarre because when a fly hits, they don't half go with a crack, proper loud. Anyway, so that's that there. And as I say, it's the time of year for all the blue bottles are coming in. And, way back door and up and outside. And we've got beautiful blue skies. So here for an hour, gonna have some tea, have a bath, do some washing up, and heading back to the nursery for a short visit. I found the bits that I was looking for. Sent Sandra a message. She said they were on the windowsill in the kitchen. I did look, and for some reason, I couldn't see them. So that's done for tomorrow when she comes with her mum. It's just started to rain again. It's just gone very, very grey out there. And it's time for me and Russia. So we just had some chicken, haven't we, Rash? We're going to head back to the nurseries.
Hey.
And we're back. So I've just come through that grey cloud. We've got blue sky over here. Bonkers. Absolutely, completely bonkers. Right. Back for the night. A bit of an idea. Which I might go into later. So, those of us that were watching a Travel Chores vlog a while back, Dan pinched my chess champion trophy out of my trophy cabinet. So I thought it's about time I started to get some more trophies. So I'm sort of thinking, what's going on here? What have we got? What have we got here? So I've got, I don't know, some different games with the bowls, Skittles. I'm not sure what the egg boxes are here for. Twister. I'm thinking Jenga champion. I could become a Jenga tiddlywinks. I don't want to be a winker, do I? I don't know what that is. So I'm thinking maybe we need to be putting out some challenges. Possibly. Some ideas. Right, so I didn't video me walking Rashi this morning. We got to the gate. Sorry. Wellington's on. Physically, the barrier, then Rashi just pulled back because it was raining. So I started off with a great big raincoat on. And it's just bobbins, absolute bobbins weather-wise. So Sandra is going to be back on her way from Shroud in Gloucestershire to the bungalow this afternoon. Not sure what time? I'm guessing late afternoon. They're going to be back with their mum. So keep watching the video because I might go and see Sandra and Barbara when they get here and get a few words off them to see how their weekend went. Never rains here. Right, so yesterday I mentioned over here and rain got in the way and all the rest of it. So I've got remnants from my old awning that I stored in what was the old garage last year. And then with all the chaos that ensued, it ended up getting a bit scattered. And I thought I'd lost the canvas, so that's here, it's been here for ages. So I'm going to try and compress that up and get it into a bag. That's me, all the bits and bobs that belong with it. And then I've got other stuff that's sort of in this corner here. So I'm just going to get out and free up a little bit of space. I think I've got some spare poles here as well. That's Dave's stuff. So let me try and get this lot out. So I've dug out my old awning. I might order a couple of little ratchet straps just to pull the canvas in a little bit tighter. This doesn't look like anything's happened, but it has. I'm trying to remember now whether somebody's left these poles that used to be on a seasonal pitch, and they're old poles. But anyway, weigh it in for scrap. Bobbins. And say I had a couple of pigeons in here the other day as well, and I don't know what they were doing, but they were doing something. Oh God, demijohn. Not too sure where that's come from, but that's been here since I came here. We keep moving it around and around and around. No idea where that's come from. Oh, that's what I was looking for. Right, that's what I was looking for. This place is just... I'll never explain it. We have now got a mystery has been solved from yesterday's video. There's a story behind this. Right, Julie, do you want to explain what's been going on here?
Well, we're away and it's Father's Day, and so Dave here...
Killer Dave
was a bit upset because he won't be getting any cards. So one daughter says, I'll take you out for a meal, and then the other one says, I have to wait till you come back. And he went, and then I told her, so why don't you post it? But when she posted it, she put two dad on it. She didn't put who. So Neil was confused who it was from, so he's had to open it.
Opened it up yesterday. Happy Father's Day. So next time, tell your daughter, because we weren't too sure when he said dad, whether it was one of the ducklings I sent it over to the dad duck. I have actually read this out on yesterday's vlog, so happy Father's Day.
Yeah, but where's the £20 that was in it?
In fact, we're on Dave's again, aren't we? Sorry, Dave's, don't mention there's too many Dave's in this cafe. Regional dialect here, right. Balms, Dave. That is a balm.
If you want to call that a balm, Kate,
yeah,
move back to Manchester.
Across the border?
You're in Lincolnshire now.
Still a balm, Kate.
Eat properly.
I need some cheese. I need some chalk from Dave and Tracy, because that sign outside, I'm going to put up bacon balms available.
No.
I've just had a couple sat here from Worsley in Manchester, and they agreed it's balms.
No, it's not.
Balms.
How can that be a balm?
Balms is about six bigger, aren't they?
That's a balm. It's a balm. A roll. I might accept a roll.
No, but you get a hot dog sausage in a roll.
Yeah.
That's a finger.
No.
It's very confusing. Never rains at the nurseries. It's just always blue sky, sunshine, things like that. Flags are flying in the distance. There's some monster kites up. Beautiful day. So, is it going to rain or is it not going to rain? Just had a message from Sandra. They're going to be back. So Sandra and Barbara are going to be back late afternoon. So I'm not too sure I'm going to eat there or not, but I'm coming back here tonight to stay. Let's wander down and I'll say hello to Rasha. I'm sure she's okay. Beautiful. What passed that a few times?
What's that? Oh, my chess trophy. 2023.
The campsite warden chess trophy.
I'm not going to say that. What are you doing?
2023 chess champion. Right.
Hey, I don't think so.
I'll be back.
I will be back.
I've got some plans as well coming up over the next couple of weeks, Dan. Yeah.
There's a thief on site.
Yeah, and Dan, if we catch the thief, do we give them the trophy over the red?
Well, we don't catch any thieves, do we? We catch thieves.
Yeah, thieves
get caught.
They do indeed. Right,
not cashed.
I've not done any questions with you on my lucky dip, have I?
Good.
I might do that later.
Okay, as long as it's not too personal.
No, I'll try not to be. I've got a bit of a weird afternoon this afternoon.
Yeah, you've got my awning to put down. My suitcase is to pack.
We've got rain on the forecast, haven't we?
Yeah.
I don't know. I'm going to go and revisit my trophy cabinet.
No, you don't need to do that.
It'll be fine. Right. No, nobody under. Oh, hello, Rasha. Oh, you're fast asleep. Hello, baby. Are you completely fast asleep? Are you fast asleep? Oh, dearie. Oh, look at you. Oh, fast asleep. Good girl. Oh, what were you dreaming about?
Cracker time. Oh, pulling a cracker, are we?
We're going to pull a cracker. Oh, hang on a minute. Have you ever pulled a cracker on your pitch before?
No.
Right, give me a pull, Dan.
Oh.
You win. Go on. You've got to put your hat on. And is there a joke or a task?
He's got a hat.
Got to put the hat on. Yeah, lob that in. All right. Oh, God. Well, these may be tasks on these crackers. Look at that there.
Why, Chris? Is this seriously the quality you went for this Christmas?
Yeah.
That is the worst Christmas hat I've ever seen in my life.
I think that looks splendid.
Merry Christmas.
Okay, go on then.
How do you keep cool at a football match?
Oh, it's football. England playing today.
How
do you keep cool? How do you keep cool at a football match?
You stand next to a fan.
That's great, that. That's
rubbish.
Oh, dear, marvellous. Hey.
Right,
what have you got?
Oh, it's a word search.
Right, now then. Now, you're not to look here now, but pick a strip and read it out. No cheating.
Oh, that's a very easy one for me.
Right, what's the question?
Is there an ex with whom you'd consider reconciling?
Ooh.
No.
Ooh.
Definitely not.
Ooh. That was easy. In fact, go on, grab another one. Come on. Let's get something a bit more revealing. All right, what's this one now?
What's your least favourite memory from college?
Oh. Did you go to college?
I did. I've not got very many memories of my college years. I do remember one bad thing what happened. Oh no, that were in school.
Well, go on, we'll go to school, we'll do. I didn't go to college, maybe.
Well, my teacher, I was just being a bit gobby in class, as you know, and my teacher came round with some papers and went like that on the back of my head. Paper cut down my face.
Is that it?
Yeah. It was bad, wasn't it?
No, we used to have
least favourite memory.
Those of a certain age, back in Manchester where I come from, Bradbury Secondary School, Mrs. Ezard, the music teacher, misbehaved with her, knuckles out, drumsticks on your knuckles. Have you ever had that?
Yeah, well, I used to play it, knuckles.
Jimmy Clitheroe, nose and crosses on your arse.
I've just thought of another one.
Go on then.
A college one. We played blind date, like a students' union thing, a blind date. I was one of the three contestants.
Right.
And the girl picked me.
Oh yeah, as a blind date.
It was just like blind date, proper blind date.
So she wasn't blind.
No, right? No.
All oh, right, okay.
It was
right,
like the blind date show.
Right, okay.
And she picked me. Now I was 16. I've just got to college, and I looked about 13.
Yeah.
She were about 21, and she looked about 25, and she was tall, and she was really good looking. Anyway, she picked me, and we won a date to go bowling, right, at Keighley. And then after the show, all right, excited, really looking forward to this date. And after the show, she came up to me. She says, can I buy that ticket off you? She didn't want to go with me.
Oh. So when you were younger, you had a thing about taller, older women?
Not really.
You just said you did.
She was just nice. I'll tell you why. Because she had a thing for the student union president who looked a bit like Dave Gahan, the lead singer of Depeche Mode.
Depeche Mode.
I looked like a very young version of him at the time.
Right, okay.
So she had a bit of a soft spot for me, but she preferred to go on a date with him because he looked even more like him because he were older.
So she wanted you to be her little personal little Jesus?
Yeah, someone. Yeah.
those that know will know.
Dave, so your buddy was here.
Yes.
A week ago. Killer Dave. Killer Clive.
Yeah.
Yeah, jumped, stamped on the mole. Sorry about the offensive, if I caused any offence about the mole being stepped on, but slide to the left. Slide to the right. Yeah. But I think because you're now at the point of retirement, you've got your retirement hat on. I think because you're with us for a week, aren't you?
Yeah.
So I think we need to give you a new title over the course of this week. Have you ever judged any competitions at all?
Hey, I go all over the world.
Okay.
Judging competitions.
Because I thought that this week when you're here, yeah. Obviously I'm not going to be here for 2 days, but I thought we could have. We can open up and I don't know, we'll announce that we're having a Skittle Championship. We've never had a Skittle Championship at the nurseries. I used to be the Skittle Champion in the regional finals in 1984, in 1995, I think it was. Right. Actually got through to the regionals. So yeah, we could have Skittles and a few other things.
Yeah.
Right, so I've ended up with a bit of a mystery here. So relinquishing your... your past experience. So I was here yesterday, funny enough. Oh, these have appeared overnight. These were flattened yesterday. God, that's a long, that's a long one, that, isn't it? I've never seen one of them before. Instead of being a mole hill, that's a mole trail, that, isn't it?
Yeah.
So that's an underground tunnel, that, isn't it? So this fella's here. Now, oh no, they've come up overnight. And I was here yesterday on my mower, so I levelled these. So this little bugger's here, and then I did a video called CSI's Crime Scene Investigation. So I thought the mole that Killer Clive had stood on was the culprit, but I think we've got a bit of a infestation of moles.
Yeah.
So down here,
I think the mole that Clive got.
So you think it's
looking for a bit of romance.
A bit of love?
Yes.
He wanted to be a loved up mover.
Yeah, well, I think so. And he was moving across here.
So I think that's a separate mole to that. I think we've got three or four moles down here. And then down here. So down here now, where are we on the end? Pitch number 7. Pitch number 8. As you can see, I've been demolishing these, been working on them. There's a big mole here, isn't there?
Yeah.
And you can see where I yesterday mowed him over. So your mate, Killer Clive, was pitched here. And then the loved up mole was apparently, he crawled out the edge here. Now there's no mole hills on the camping side. So I thought it was that mole. But where's he come from if there's no mole hill?
Well,
or was he just randomly looking for love?
He's randomly walked through there, hasn't he, and decided I'm going to pitch up there. Must like pitch 9.
But this mole is no longer with us, so we've now got another mole.
Yeah, he might have been going there for a bit of...
bit of love?
Yeah.
Love of the nurseries.
Yeah.
There's a certain age, we'll remember. Was it Lionel Richie did Love on the Rocks, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah, but look at this bugger. Not good, is it? Rolled it all yesterday. Missed. I think we need a plan. My loyal viewers out there, my chums, if you spot a mole, let me know. Right, this is Killer Dave. Judge Dave. He's got a TV program, is it Judge Jury something, isn't there? Is it
Judge Judy?
Judy, is that the one? Yeah. As we're coming towards school holidays,
those of a certain age will remember just when school holidays were approaching, you used to have sports days. Do you remember sports? It was a massive thing, wasn't it? Especially when you were like about eight and you're going to do like the egg and spoon race.
Yeah, and if you forgot your shorts, you had to go do it in your underpants, didn't you? Yeah.
Did you?
Yeah, we did at our school.
Yeah. Is that in Lincoln?
Yeah.
Well, that explains a lot, doesn't it?
No excuse. No excuse not to be in it, you see.
No, so I thought, obviously, over the course of the next week while you're here, and because your killer role is... I think you need to be Judge Dave.
Yeah.
Or Dave the Judge. What?
Judge. Well, now I've gone into retirement at work, and I've got all this free time, and I've been taking all these exams now to be a proper judge on all games.
Are you qualified?
Oh, yeah, I am now, yeah.
So... If you ever stay with us at a nursery, you come into our information. We've got like a games cupboard with things to do on rainy days. So I just thought, over the course of the week you're here, I thought we'd have some talent challenges. So I think I'm going to put out each morning, if anybody wants to do the challenge, they have to come to reception, sign themselves in, and then we'll do the challenge at some point in the day. And if nobody turns up, obviously it defaults to me. So I think you've got some ideas of some of the challenges over the next week. What sort of challenges are we going to do, Dave?
I thought maybe we'd do the Connect Four.
Connect Four Championship. Hang on a minute. Let's have a... I got through to the World Connect Four Euro Champions. I think it was 1971 when Connect Four was first coming out. Yeah, I actually got through to the final, the World Champion, to being the Connect Four... Champion. Okay, we can have a Connect Four championship.
And then I thought maybe basketball.
Basketball. Hang on a minute. Now then, the nursery's basketball champion. I was never very good at basketball, but when I was little, we had the under-18s regional basketball team, and I was a young member. I think I was 7 years old at the time, and I got through to the finals on that. So I could become the nursery's basketball champion 2024. I'm looking forward to these challenges. Do I get a trophy?
I think there's trophies being organised.
Right. I can do that. Right.
Yeah, and then we'll carry on the next day with the drafts. How's that?
Drafts. Well, last year I did become the nursery's 2023 chess champion.
Yeah.
Thrashed down at that. I don't know if you saw that or not.
I mean, my
checkmate move was the best ever. I think I could become a draft champion. Retro.
Yeah.
So I went through to the finals for the Northwest draft champion, but I was getting on. I think I was 11 or 12. And I actually got through to the finals on this one. But you know what? I ended up not really liking chess. I become a backgammon player.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. But yeah.
Was that before or after the chess? You became a grandmaster on the chess?
Oh, I've been doing chess since I was three. I was born with a castle in my mouth.
Oh, right.
Yeah.
That's why you talk like that.
Explains a lot, doesn't it?
Yeah.
So, I think before you go, I think I could become the chess champion of the nurseries 2024. I think that...
Yeah.
If I win any of these, I mean, my trophy cabinet is going to have a lineup of golden, expensive big trophies, isn't it?
Yeah. Okay. Now, the next one, this one's going to test you.
What are we going to do with this?
How about a game of Skittles?
Oh, Skittles. Now.
Now.
Now, we've never had a Skittle championship.
We've gone to the heavyweight games now.
Those are for if you end up with a madman on the campsite, say no more, you could use them and lop somebody on the head with them, couldn't you?
Yeah.
Skittle champion. Now, I've never actually entered a Skittle championship, but I reckon I could come out of this winning with a trophy.
Do you think so?
I do think so, yeah.
Well, you know, I'm going to be fair and above board on all of these games.
No. I'm just hoping people turn up.
I'm not favouring anybody.
No. Well, you wouldn't do that. You can't do that.
No. It's in training. Not allowed to favour anybody.
I think we need one other activity over the course.
Another one. How about... I think Dan used to call it...
Bowls. Bowl. He doesn't know a bowl, but he doesn't know a bit of bull between a bowl, does he? Bowls. balls.
You'll give him a bit of leeway from Yorkshire.
But a bit of cheating went on with the bulls last year that was going on. Yeah. So I think because of all the cheating, I think we need to revisit who's going to become the nurseries 2024 bulls champion, don't you?
I think so. Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
So I think we're lined up for some activities here. I'm looking forward to it. It's just a bit like school's sports day coming up, isn't it?
So Dan, when you watch this, make sure you're
in each beer, get his name down each morning.
Got me down.
Yeah. If you're not down, put your name down.
Yeah.
That's it, isn't it?
You ain't got your name down by 10 o'clock, that's it.
No.
Because you've got to arrange everybody to be. And the game's got to arrange it all, so.
Do I have to wear shorts? And if I don't, I'm not doing it in my underpants.
No, you can't.
Sparrow legs. We don't want sparrow legs, do we? No. Right, I'm looking forward to it, Dave. Thank you. Yeah. Are you looking forward to it?
Yeah, it's going to be a busy week.
Yeah, very busy week. Excellent. Thank you. Look at that. We're waiting for the storm. Right, I've just had a message from Sandra that they've now left. And should be here by what I would call tea time. So I'm going to finish the video off here because I think this one's gone quite long enough. And then we'll be starting off tomorrow's video, the next vlog, with Sandra and her mum all being well. So a little bit of silliness in this one, which we need in our lives on a beautiful day for the nurseries where it never rains, the sun always shines. And I've got a few challenges coming up ahead. If you've not least subscribed to this channel, and you can do, it would be wonderful to have you. It costs nothing to do that. There's a link down there. See down there? If you're on a television, press your down key on your remote control. And if you can't subscribe, don't worry. If you have subscribed, big thumbs up. If you're able to give the video a thumbs up, we always give a thumbs up back. Thank you, my chums, for watching. And all being well tomorrow, I'll bring you another vlog.